No we're not cooking rice today. This is the font for previous video. It has been in here for a couple of days, but we keep for a few more, just in case, because there was moisture in the camera. No point turning on unless moisture is gone. Today instead, we cook some food on this limited edition cutting board. Next time we cook onion. But today, I show you the baby. Also, eggs, dill, and mayonnaise. Let's begin. Yes, Boris! The bay. Also known as the source of ultimate Slav flavor. But what exactly is it? It's a very common ingredient in Slavic dishes, mostly used in soup. You add one, you add three, it's up to you. But what does it do exactly? So let's see your cooking board. You give it a try and... Something's missing. Salt, yes, it's probably salt. So you add the salt as much as you think you need. And attempt number two. Блять, it's still missing. It is missing that sensual touch. That бабушка's touch. It is missing the bay leaf. Or maybe two. And you let it boil for at least 10 more minutes. You know, you never actually know that you need the bay leaf. Because you do not actually taste it. You just have to feel it. Если тебе сукей, то leave it in the soup while you're eating. Just do not eat the leaf itself. It's just horrible, I have tried. Once you're done eating, you can throw it back in the soup for the next meal to find. But in the end, you can dry it and use it again next time for many times. There is no actual limit where you can use the bay leaf. So go ahead, experiment. Use it in your favorite recipe and let me know how it turned out. I will not say that boiling eggs is simple. But if you think that you probably should not be watching this video. So let's see you find egg in the refrigerator. Is it boiled? Is it raw? What you do? Do you crack it open? No, instead you spin the egg. You see, a raw egg is much harder to spin. Also, if you try to stop raw egg from spinning, it keeps going. Sorcery ammo. Keep your friends at the tent for weeks. Now let's compare to boiled egg. Now how can I be sure this is boiled egg, not just raw? You give it the same spin. Whoop! Well, this does happen. Also, you can spin on the chip like that. What was he talking about? Ah yes, if you try to stop this egg, it actually stopped. Now let's try boiling. So there is a large group of people that believe that boiled egg with raw metal is somehow superior. But around here, we not do that. You see, this is what I called it could have used a good 5 more minutes of boiling. Type of egg. This has been boiled for 8 minutes. This one is 10 minute egg. If sentry shining back at you, then the cooking is not done. Now this is what I call a boiled egg. This is the 12 minute egg. Here we have two stages of boiling. If it's done or is not done. Cooked or raw. Is a boiled egg or salmonella. You present anything less than this to бабушка salad making, you get a rolling pin to the head. Now let me show you the cooking. Now whatever you have heard, eggs are put into boiling water, not cold. Because when you try opening egg, that you put into cold water and cut it 12 minutes, you get soup. Do not attempt to put salt into water, it does nothing. Use palmillinator to lower the eggs into water. Do not use your fingers, because water at boiling temperature is bad for the human skin. Start the countdown timer when you put the eggs in the water. Is this spare time to practice your card shuffling skills, so you not look like debil next time you play дурак with your comrades? Is this your card? Yes it is, they're all my cards! Now that the 12 match is done, we can... Shut up, yeah! We can do small experiment. You might have heard that when you put boiled eggs into cold water, then it make peel come off easy, but I sure am not easy just foreign propaganda. Let's put one egg just on this plate to cool down. We leave one egg in the water just how it is. Ah, блин! And one egg we check and put in cold water. No ice required. And let it cool down for about 20-30 minutes. And here we have the result. On the letter egg number one, cool down in cold bath for 30 minutes. We mark this with the card number 3 are sausages. The next one is air cold for 30 minutes, marked by the flavor of onions. And the last one stayed in the hot water for 30 minutes. 10 of cabbages for this one. Now even stories that are true than this first one should be so easy to peel that I forget all my troubles. And the rest of these two so hard to peel that I would rather slam my fingers in the drawer than continue peeling. Let's begin. I'm not debil, this card is actually plastic covered, so nothing happened. It's a special Boris kitchen card. Aha, look at it, very easy to peel. The shell come off in pretty much two large pieces. The egg white is soft, but yellow is hard. Just like egg should be. We take a look inside, and we have a perfectly cooked egg. Nothing is shining back, the egg is ready for eating. Let's try egg number two. This is air cool. Now this is what you would normally do if you not have cold water at hand. You pull them out, put on the plate. Besides, you're cooking like 30, 50, 100 eggs at once. The type of battery expected to put it in. And look at that. Peel came off very easy. Exactly two pieces. And let's look inside what we have. I want you to know it is exactly the same. Egg number 3. This has been in the warm water. I would actually say this is a bit hot. Now this is what happens if you forget your eggs in the water. You forget to take them out. And after 30 minutes you just realize you were making potato salad. And just as expected, nothing different on this one. Now if you are egg specialist, you might be screaming right now, saying Boris, this is way overcooked compared to other ones, this is non-eatable, and what you know, this is exactly the same. So you see, not point wasting cold water, it ended up all the same. Just remember 12 minutes in boiling water, and ready for eating. A basic task, I know, but it was requested by a subscriber. Remember, no maneuver in the kitchen is too basic. Always keep experimenting and challenging yourself, and never, never be afraid to fail. Insert a small bit of oil. Now, oil has a double effect on pan. First, it shows you how hot the pan is. If it flows very fast, the pan is very hot. It's also a visual representation of how much of the pan is lubricated. This amount of oil is completely enough to fry like 3 eggs on this pan. As I said in previous video, you do not always need oil. But if you consider a small correction, this pan is a bit пиздец, then you will need to use oil. Shuffle it around a bit more, the pan is not covered. It is warm, yes, it is nice and hot. Check out your chicken produce. Here is a nice way to impress your friends. Hold it like this, thick end at the top. Do not smash it at the pan like that. Just a small, опа, small opening. Now hold top part with two fingers, and pull bottom one apart. And the cooking begins. Do not use full heat, use like medium or slightly above medium heat. Now, this is where people get confused. How to blend, you know how to season the food? Well, you see, I have the layer system. And one layer of each flavor you want. For pepper this easy, you can see the black. With salt, also not high. Take a pinch and spread it across. That is all. Season on just one side, not both. But how do you know when to flip it? Just like pancake, you flip it when you can. When it is no longer stuck to the pan, you can take it and flip it over. Do not use metal objects, because they damage the pan. Take immediate addition Boris spatula if you need. Or if you're feeling very adventurous, just do the Boris Blend 360, which is actually 180, but we not speak of that. Just front and up, front and up. And that is how it is done. How do you know if egg is finally done? You just poke it a little bit. If the yellow part is cooked, it is hard. Also, it should come loose from the pan. I mean, it has passed, now it is done. Look how hard it is. Plate, some mayonnaise on top, and it is ready for eating. But Boris, how much mayonnaise should I add? Well, thank you for asking. Boris, it's so much mayonnaise, it cannot be good for you. And do you really expect me to believe you eat that much mayonnaise? Yes? And no, yes I do eat all this mayonnaise, because it tastes amazing. And no, if you only eat mayonnaise the whole day, it is not good for you. But you use it on food, normal food. Food that I have cooked. And I'm in control of the amount of mayonnaise. So if you ask how much to put, put as much as you like. This is no weight loss video, блять. This is a future project. So let's see you making a booty, bro. A nice thick slice of everything you like. You whip out your imported high-quality Riga Gold spreads. You can already smell the heaven coming into your nose. But what is missing? The mayonnaise. So how much would you add a thick slice as well, блять? Come on! What, you think I'm joking? I'm not joking. Let me joke bad food, suka. No such thing as too much mayonnaise. As long as it's proportionate, then it's fine. But if you really need an amount, then just like seasoning the egg, use one layer. You just made a hot plate of pelmeni. The steam coming up smells so good. But you didn't want something special. You had some dill, but it's not how you had some dill. What are these branches doing in my food? No, you chop it there, small piece. And from no less than 42 centimeters, you let it fall, rain from the heavens. Now that is one tasty dish. Mayonnaise on top, boom! And that is how it is done. And that is all for today's lesson. Now go and practice at home, at friend's place or at babushka's place. But remember, as I said before, do not be afraid to fail. Thank you for watching, stay chick-breaky, I will see you next time.